Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. Now we are explaining programming in C. One important note, on 11/4/2020, we are conducting live session on how a programmer can think. So we are also taking n number of examples and giving brief idea about how best we need to think in a programming side. Okay, so today we are discussing about swapping of two numbers. Generally, people know that two logics, one is using third variable and second one is without using third variable. So in the without using third variable, we are giving sum and subtraction combination is one and XOR combination is one, division and multiplication is one, and single line we can also write the entire program. So these things can be discussed in this session. Okay. So swapping of two numbers. Actually, what is the meaning of swapping of two numbers? In computer programming, the act of swapping two variables refers to mutually exchanging the values of the variables. Usually this is done with the data in memory. The different techniques: using third variable, without using third variable addition and subtraction mechanism, without using third variable XOR, without using third variable but both numbers should be non-zero multiplication and division mechanism, swapping in a single line. So I am telling you very clearly. So this is the 1000 memory location, this is the 2000 memory location, named as A and named as B, here 10 and 20. After swapping, it is 20, it is 10, and we need to change. For this, we are using different mechanisms. So go to first one with using third variable. So with using third variable means we are taking third variable, that is T. So this is A, this is B, and we are taking T. So initially A is 10 and B is 20, T is empty. Okay. After that, we are applying T is equal to A. What is the value of A is assigned to T. So 10 is assigned to T. B will not be reflected. Now, what is the value of B? B is assigned to A. So 20 is assigned to A. So T will not be reflected. After that, what is the value of T? T is assigned to B. So that obviously this is assigned to B. So in this way, initially we are taking 10 and 20. After that, it gets 20 and 10. Allocate memory for variable T. This could take a lot of time or very little time, depends on the long ways. And second one is, unnecessarily we are using third memory location. That's why this long ways is little bit disadvantageous. So now moving to the program. So initially we need to declare three variables A, B and T, enter the value of A, enter the value of B, and we have print the value of A and B before swapping. After that we need to apply the technique. After that we need to print them A and B values. So A is 25, B is 45, A 25, B 45. After swapping, A is 45 and B is 25 you will get. I will do a practical in the next video. So the next one is swapping without using third variable addition and subtraction mechanism. So simple thing, first is A is equal to A plus B. Okay, the value of A is 10 and B is 20. A is equal to A plus B means A is equal to 10 plus 20, that is equal to 30. B will not be reflected. So A is 30 and B is 20. Next statement, B is equal to A minus B. A is 30 and B is 20, that is equal to 10 is available. So that's why it changes. Next is A is equal to A minus B. It means that 30 minus 10, that is equal to 20 assigned to A. So that is the reason we are exchanging the values. Same, previous programming all same. Only thing is the green statements are changed in the entire process. Okay. So remaining, enter the A, enter B and print before swapping, after swapping, these statements are common to all the programs. Only thing is the logic part, these three lines are placing crucial role in the program. So this is the main logic. So logic are changing from previous program to this program. And the third one is swapping without using third variable and XOR. Before discussing about this entire program, I will tell you what is the meaning of XOR. XOR means, so if you take ABE and AX are being. So 1 1 0 1 1 0 0 0 0 0 will become 0, 1 1 become 0. These two are means both the symbols are equal, then it is 0. Otherwise, opposite symbols will get 1. In this context, XR means this. Okay. Now, first we are applying A and B. So, A is 30. Okay, initially, so A is 10. So, 10 equivalent binary value is this. So, 20 equivalent value is this. After this 0 0 0 1 0 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 0 1 1, remaining all are zeros. So this is equivalent to 30. So after applying this and we are assigning to A, this is the values change. So after that, A and B again we need to perform and assign to B, so that now the value of A is 30. 30 value is binary equivalent is this, and 20 binary equivalent is this. And we perform 0 0 0 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 0 1 1 1 0, remaining all are zeros. So we get 10. So we assign to 10. Similarly, we need to apply third one. Automatically you will get 20 and 10. So we can also write in a single line this. So m cap is equal to n cap is equal to m cap is equal to n. So first this this will be happened, next this, followed by this. These three lines can be written in simple form. So the code also reflects only in this location. Okay, so remaining parts are not at all reflected. In practically, I will show you how these programs are executed in the next video, but initially I am telling you how differently we are using it. Okay, so coming to the next technique, that is without using third variable, both the non-zero and multiplication and division technique. So first we multiply, next we divide two times. So first we multiply 10 into 20, we will get 200, and 20 is same. Next one, 200 by 10 and assign to B. So sorry, 200 by 20, so 0 0 10, 10 is assigned to B. So automatically B value changes. Now 200 by 10 is equal to 20, so that is assigned to A. That is the way we are communicating. So the logic, so initially here small things are increased. Why? Because A and B are 0, then this logic will not be work out. So that we are checking A is not equal to 0 and B is not equal to 0, then only this process will be work out. So we check this condition followed by the statements here, why, how we are using it. So single line statement. So initially we wrote A is equal to A plus B, B is equal to A minus B, and A is equal to A minus B. These three statements are written in a single line called B is equal to A plus B minus A is equal to B. So if you write like this, automatically you will get the result. So I think it is not equal, it is minus. Okay, thank you.